Welcome to Bitch Talk, booze interviews straight from the heart of San Francisco. I'm Erin. That's Ange.
Hi.
That's Char.
Hello.
You can find us at bitchtalkpodcast.com where you can sign up for our monthly e-news.
For behind-the-scenes videos and two-minute clips of our interviews, head to our YouTube channel and subscribe.
You can find us every other Thursday morning at 9:30 a.m. at BFF.fm.
And if you like what you hear, rate and subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts. For the love of God, do it. It really helps.
Hey, Bitch Talkers. It's the end of 2020, and we thought we'd regroup and just say hello and goodbye to this year. Say hello to each other because we haven't seen each other in a while, but goodbye to this year. And our good friend, teammate, sister from another mister, Ange, said that she wanted to jump on and felt like she had the capacity to do so. So we were like, yeah, let's do it.
I was in a strong place when I texted you that I could do this, Limber.
Minute by minute. Yep.
So, to those of you that listened to our last Basic Bitch, I talked about how I was in LA taking care of my parents. You know, I may have made light of it. You know, that's just how I cope. I take what I'm doing here very seriously. And I lost my dad last week. And I just wanted to honor him briefly. You know, he was my hero.
And I would say, I'll help you out here. I would also say that out of all of your sisters, I feel like you're basically girl Tony. You are.
For better or worse, yeah.
You are your father's daughter, like 125,000,000%. And, we literally just had Tony on our 500th event episode, which, you know, he was very Tony about it and just invited himself. And we're like, cool, whatever you want to do, dude. So,
and he was the highlight of it all.
Yeah. And he was like the star. Like, I don't even know why we were on.
Like, we worked so hard to get a well-rounded group of people. Like,
so hard. So hard. Yes. So hard.
And he stole the show, and it really ended up being his swan song. Like, he loved performing.
Yeah.
He performed as Elvis, his hero. And you know, he was the most important man in my life, you know, the heart and soul of our family. He taught me how to laugh, how to live life to the fullest. But you know, I can't be sad about it, because he lived an awesome life. 81 years full of laughter. And even his last few months, I introduced Spotify to him. So he was just listening to music. Just his life was full of music. 2 days before he died, all of my sisters were with my parents. It was just my sisters and my parents. I have four sisters. And I can't remember the last time it was just us. You know, none of my nephews were there, none of my brother-in-laws. So we had, you know, a really great day together. And, he's still making us laugh. I'm going through all his stuff and I'm finding he was just full of jokes. He said the secret to life was making at least one person laugh every day. And he did that. He did that every day, at least one person. And he's still making us laugh. Like, I'm finding, I sent a picture to Erin. He used to make fake money with his face on it, and he would use it everywhere, at the bank, at the restaurant. Like, he would try to pay with this $100 bill with his face on it. So I'm finding all these $100 bills, the $1 million bills, whatever. And I'm even finding, like, he's going to make it. You know, the face was cut out, but he hadn't come around to making it yet. And, you know, he had this monkey ID.
Oh, God.
That yes. He would use.
Always.
He got pulled over by a cop once, and he gave it to the cop, and the cop was so mad. It was just, you know, that was just him. So he's still making us laugh, every day. And I wanted to talk about we had a novena. We just ended our 9-day novena, which Shar is probably familiar with. I had to introduce Erin to it because I forgot you're not a woman of the cross, Erin.
Yeah, I had no idea what she was talking about when she texted it. So I'm like, okay, I guess I have to Google.
Or the PI.
I don't really know.
Yeah, I was like,
yeah,
oh,
I don't know either thing.
Yeah, we're busy with the novena. And she's like, okay, I'm going to Google that, but okay. You know,
hey, learning and growing.
Do you have your cheat sheet?
Oh, I needed a sheet. Some of the prayers, I don't remember all of them, but so.
Who's the reader before we move on?
We all took turns. My sisters and I took turns.
I'm always the one that's stuck that has to do the lead. The end part where everybody asks to pray for them. And I have to say all of these things. And then I had to look. And so like by the end of it, after 40 days, I'm like, I know all of these by heart.
Yeah. Well, thankfully we're just doing 9 days. We did 9 days. And it's funny because, it really does help. And I was thinking about it and I was telling my friend, you know, maybe my dad's last joke is that his death will bring me back to Christ.
Oh, I was a little worried about that. I was worried.
No, listen, you know what it is? It's meditative. It is. These are prayers that I went to 12 years of Catholic school. I went to Sunday church every day until college. So it's meditative. And, you know, we Zoomed with family members. Some of my high school friends from LA even joined in, ones that have two kids at home, an awesome 8-month-old baby, they're joining. And it's just, you know, we're all together and it's meditative. I don't listen to the words. It's just so second nature that that's what helps, you know, all of us being together.
And being in that space.
Yeah, and spending that time. And it really helps my mom too. So, you know, that was really beautiful. We just ended the novena yesterday. And I was funny because, you know, we're just planning things. Now we got to plan this. And I looked at my sister and I was like, I don't have anything to wear to a funeral. I did not anticipate this. My only options were bitch talk sweater or onesie. Those are the only black outfits I had. So we have to get clothes for that. And, you know, I'm just really grateful. In 2013, I interviewed my parents. And I say it all the time, you know, just, I know that I'm lucky to have had a really good relationship with them, and that's not everyone's story, but just if you can record it, great, but just ask them like what, you know, I sat down with my dad all day and I just talked to him about everything. And it's just like so special to have that now. And there's so much we don't know about our parents that, you know, would really help you understand them a lot more and appreciate them a lot more, you know, for all their imperfections. And so I'm just really grateful to have that to look back to. And one other word of advice, my dad was in the Army. He served for 8 years and we can't find his DD-214s, which are his discharge papers. And you need those in order to have a military funeral, which we know that would be just the most important thing. So I'm just tearing the house down, trying to find this paperwork from 60 years ago. So I would suggest, you know, if you're talking to your parents, ask about these things, you know, it's the most important paper for a veteran, you know, so I'm tearing down the house looking for that. Just little bits of advice.
Dude, passwords.
That's passwords.
Really important, you guys.
Yeah, just passwords FYI. For bills and investments. If they have, I don't know, just all these things, just talk to your parents and I don't know. It's all good. Just talk to your parents. And
you know, if you don't mind me saying, I remember we were, I mean, I don't know. I mean, shit changes really fast in life. And I think this moment is just a reminder of that. Not even moment. What's happened with you and your family. But, you know, we were in Tahoe literally days before all this happened. And I remember Ange talking out loud to like our, you know, my fiance and our friend Courtney about interviewing your parents, and had that conversation about just talking to them. But I don't know. It's just, we went from relaxing to the fullest to then, you know, you went from adulting to the fullest times a million. So.
Yeah, it was the day after I got back from Tahoe that we came to LA. Yeah, so. But, you know, Jeff made me laugh because he said there you're going to legally change your name to Irene because my dad yes. called Aaron Irene.
I'm Irene officially.
For some reason, one day she was just Irene now. He yes. knew your name for years right. and years.
Yeah, it's fine. It's
so totally we're going to be calling you Irene now.
Right. Yeah. Oh, no. I'll always, you know, I don't order from DoorDash, but I always call it Jordash. So
yeah.
Because of your dad.
Yeah, Jordash.
And yeah. I mean, your dad leaves an impression because our neighbor, Steven, met your dad once at the Pig and Whistle, which is on my corner. And he's like, he brings that up so many times, like so often. And like, he loved that moment or moments with your dad and what a jokester he was. I mean, he pulled out that ID on Steven, like right away with the monkey on it.
So, I mean, like that was the first thing I said to Aaron when she broke the news to me that, like, you know, I was one of the unfortunate ones that never got to meet Tony, but I was just like with your stories now and like, and just the stories you've told me over the years and, you know, and then our 500th, it's, I can picture him as like, he's it, for every Filipino family. He's that guy at the party that's he's probably Uncle Tony that yeah. tells everybody he's the guy. It's like, oh, Uncle Tony's here, and he's gonna bust out the joke or bust out a prop or something, and he's the heart of the party. So it's like I know him, you know, and from my hair I know you, so you're the mini Tony. So
yeah, I would watch him. People just flocked to him, you know. And that's rare. You can't teach something like that. So want to honor him and thank him and thank you guys for, you know, having him be a part of our 500th, because now it just makes it that much more special. And to those of you that couldn't make it, it's on our YouTube channel if you want to watch it and see him. He's at the end.
Remember when you sent that video to us? Hanch sent that video to us and goes, I don't know if you guys want to use this, guys, but here it is. It's right. funny.
I was like, hell yeah.
And we both watch it. I was like, this is the best thing we've ever
I was like, it's real cracked out. I don't know.
It didn't matter. It didn't matter. And it was a perfect ending to our 500th. So, I don't know. There's so much to be talked about grief and loss, because there's so many weird moments, but there's also so many funny moments, right? Like, mm-hmm. I feel like when Ange and I talked last week, just last week, like we were laughing and crying really hard at the same time. So mm-hmm. I don't know. It's all of it's important, and all of it, you just need to go through it. So I know a lot of people are grieving, I mean, this fucking year, obviously, and also this time of year is hard for a lot of folks. So, and I'm just saying all that to say it's okay.
It's yeah. Okay. Yeah. So. We're sending all of our love to all of you listening, and we got through this year somehow.
Well,
I
just when we thought we were getting out somewhat unscathed, like. Last week sucked the most, probably. Well,
remember when I hurt my knee and I was like, I think it could, you know, I just trying to keep perspective. Things could be worse. And I was right. Things could be worse and they got worse.
So on that note, we are shutting this shit down for the rest of this year. And just want to say thank you to everyone new and old to the podcast. Thank you for supporting us. This has been like, I mean, the silver lining is this has been a really good year for us for the podcast. And we appreciate y'all. I mean, this is 7 years, you guys. this isn't like a startup podcast. We've been around for a while, but we're still learning and growing. And thanks for riding the roller coaster of 2020 with us. It's been real, as the kids say. Do they even say that anymore?
With 120 episodes this year, I think is what we
did.
Jesus.
Is that with the Sundance stuff?
Yeah.
Is it 120 plus 60 or whatever?
120 plus 60. I'm talking about just straight up episodes that we've dropped.
Jesus Christ.
I'll get the exact number because I was just looking at it. We've done 108 episodes. We've done about 108 episodes plus our Flashback Fridays. And then that doesn't include the 70 interviews that we did at Sundance.
Oh, yeah. 70, not 60. Sorry.
500 Jesus. Years ago.
Yeah. Like 2020. Is it like 2020 AD or I don't know, 2020 BC?
I was talking to somebody. I goes, oh, last year at Sundance. And I go, no, that was 11 months ago. Not even 10 months ago.
Yeah, BC,
right,
before Corona. Yeah.
Right. I just said to Char, we're the hardest working podcast in podcast history. So there you go. You're welcome. Thanks for listening.
We got a good interview for the new year too. It's one of our favorites, I think, that we closed the year out with. Mr. Soul.
Correct. Yeah. Melissa Hazlip. Look out for that one. But y'all, if you are looking for content, we got it. This whole year is full of content. Not only just listening, but go to our YouTube page. I mean, we got a lot going on. So thanks again for riding this weird roller coaster with us of 2020. And we will see you in 2021.
If you like what you hear, rate and subscribe wherever you listen to podcasts.
For more information about us, you can head to bitchtalkpodcast.com.
This podcast is created, hosted, and executive produced by Aaron Lim.
My co-host is Angela Tabora, a.k.a. Captain Party.
The show's edited by producer Shar.
We're powered by GoTo Productions.